Hello. Good afternoon and welcome to the Polished You series. My name is Norma Efanga and I'm super excited to be in your midst again this Tuesday afternoon. How has it been for you? I know it's the beginning of the week and sometimes it's difficult to express how the week has been so far, but I'm trusting that you are having an amazing, amazing period. It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Some people might be going for lunch break here in Lagos, Nigeria. Well, some people might still be catching up on their early morning snooze, but whatever it is, the fact that you're here today, I'm super excited and I welcome you to the show. It's the Polished You series where we talk about everything refinement, everything polish, everything grooming, and we help people in the area of appearance, behavior, and communication to continue to refine themselves and continue to experience the best version of themselves and also allow others to experience this as well. So thank you for coming in. Thank you so much. So many people already joining online and it's really exciting to come again today. We are going to be talking about something really, really interesting. And what is it about? It's the power of words. Hi, how are you? You're welcome. So the power of words. I know that a lot of people don't really think about the words that they use before they use it. There is a quote that said, be careful with your words because once they are said, they can only be forgiven but not forgotten. So why is it important that we are careful about the words that we use? Because words are like knives. They can pierce. So depending on how you use them, they can either heal or they can damage a person. We are human beings made with a mind that is able to accept things in terms of words, and the words we hear every single day, we may not know how much it affects us, but it really does affect us. And you might ask, you might say, how does word affect me? Some of us are not even aware that we are a product of who we are today is a product of the kind of words that have been used on us. Growing up, what is the kind of environment that you found yourself in and what was the language that was prevalent there? Some people grew up in an environment where they're usually called names, you know, all kinds of names. You hear things like, you're stupid, you just don't have any sense at all. Can't you use your brain? You don't have a brain. I can see that you're just useless. So these are the kind of words that they grew up around. And definitely because it is something that they are used to, they are going to become a product of that. And that is what they're also going to give other people. One of my mentors will usually say, you can't give what you don't have. You can't be a loving person. You can't be an understanding person if you have not experienced it yourself. It is out of the abundance of what you have, that's what you're gonna give. So what is your word bank all about? What kind of words do we find around you? That's a question that we're gonna ask, and maybe you might want to get across to us at askcomalicha@gmail.com so that we can just know what your experience with words are are like maybe when you were growing up, or what you have been able to do to change the kind of words that you use on people around you. Now, I remember an incident when I was in secondary school, and you know, back in the days when we were in secondary schools, we used to have things like seniors that we used to attend to, like get them a bucket of water, go on chores for them, and all of that. There was this particular one that for some reason she found it really intriguing to be calling me stupid. Any little thing, maybe something I did wrong, and the next thing she just says, stupid, stupid. At some point I had to go and check the dictionary to find out what exactly is stupid and why does this person keep using this word on me. I think I was already conscious of that. And every time she said it, I just wouldn't accept it for myself, you know, because I just knew that this was not what defined me. Now, at this point, I want to be able to say that if you have come to accept the words, negative words that people have used on you over the years, then it's time to stop. It's time for you to begin to filter through what people call you. When people call you names, when my kids come and say, "Oh, mom, somebody called me this," and I say, "Is that your name?" And they say, "No." Then anytime I tell them, anytime somebody calls you something that you're not, then don't answer. Tell them you have my permission to tell whoever it is, if it's a teacher, if it's somebody older, with all sense of respect, "I'm sorry, but that's not my name. My name is this. That's who I am." Because the words we use ultimately define who we are. What kind of words do you use on your kids? What kind of words do you use on your colleagues, family members, siblings? Now, some people grew up in places where they use this word, so it doesn't mean anything, so they just use it. And then they think that that's how the society is, or, you know, that's how things are. So the next thing you see is that they now use it on other people. And then if you're not the kind of person who is used to that, you're wondering, why are you using this kind of word? Why are you using this kind of word on me? You know, so you want to tell people that, hey, I am a person of value, I'm a person of worth. So anything that doesn't represent my value or worth in life, then I will not call, I will not be known for that. I will not be called by that name because it doesn't define who I am. It doesn't define what I represent. So I'm not going to be called by a name that doesn't represent who I am. That's what you're going to tell yourself. So remember that words are powerful. Remember that words are powerful. Let me say it again. Remember that words are powerful. Remember that words are powerful. I think it was Robin Sharma that said something. He said, "Words can inspire and words can destroy." So choose them well. Which words are you using on people around you? Which words are you using on yourself? The words have power, and once they are said, it goes out into the atmosphere and begins to put things in motion for you. So when, imagine that you grew up in a setting that you continually heard, "You're stupid, you're just stupid, you're just stupid." What do you think you're going to be? What do you think you're going to end up being? You're going to end up being that person who always believes that, "Look, I'm a stupid person. I can never get anything done right. I can never be useful. I can never be a person of value." That's what is going to happen. I've met some people who just never believe. You tell them, "Oh, do you know you're so beautiful?" And they look at you like, No, I'm so ugly. I have skinny legs. I have, hello, you're welcome. I've got skinny legs. I'm not I'm not beautiful. And at some point, I actually grew up thinking that I wasn't beautiful. Now I know. Trust me, I know. Not out of pride, but I have come to begin to believe that for myself. Because what we believe actually defined us. Whatever you believe can become true. So when you look at yourself, I mean, I used to say I had so skinny legs, you know, I was this and that. I really wish that I am back to what I used to be because I've added a little bit of weight. But it's okay, you know, it's okay. It's not a problem. The point is that words are powerful. Must be mindful. We must be mindful about who uses words on us and the kind of words they use. When people use words that don't inspire you or make you progress in life, then reject it. Cut it off and say, no, this is not who I am and this doesn't represent me as a person and I reject it, whatever you're saying. Surround yourself with people who inspire you, who use words that push you, that encourage you and make you to be the best version of yourself. And then you have to learn how to use words that inspire people, that encourage people to be the best version of themselves. Because the more we use these words, the more we continue to, you know, experience this vicious circle of churning out the wrong kind of people in society that use all kinds of words, violent words, words that don't inspire greatness to, you know, and we, what's the result? We're only going to continue to see the wrong results. We cannot be like the definition of the madman who will continue to repeat himself. They say that insanity, the definition of insanity is when someone continues to repeat something over and over again the same way and expecting a different result. We can't continue to use words that don't inspire, stupid, foolish. I mean, you're just good for nothing. This is, of course, what do you expect? There's nothing good that's going to come out of that situation. So what are we going to do? We're going to use inspiring words. When you have to learn to change your words. And you have to be deliberate about it. You have to be intentional. You have to be conscious. You have to be ready. When you want to give that, you know, you're good for, you can change the word to say, you know, you can amount to something. You can be great. You can be strong. I know that there's greatness in you. You can do it. You are great. You are intelligent. You know, redefine the words that you use. And begin to see the results that you want to see. Begin to see the results that you want to see. I don't know if I'm making sense today. I'm quite sensitive about words because words can make or mar anybody. And if you're not careful, then you are going to damage somebody. Imagine the damage that has been going on for decades and generations where one parent, for example, or two parents begin to infuse this negative words in the life of a child and that child grows and becomes an adult and then the adult continues the circle on his own family or his own kids. It's going to be continuous. So we're going to be churning out generations of people who have failed. We don't want to do that. That's the bigger picture. That is the bigger picture. So change your words today. Begin to look for words that replace what you're trying to say. Even if that person is not doing well, look for a way to say the word that will help that person begin to do the right thing. So what have we discussed today? We've talked about the power of words. Words are powerful. They can either inspire or they can destroy. So we have to be mindful of the words that we use and intentionally and deliberately and consciously use words on people that will inspire them to become gradually the best version of themselves. On that note, it's a wrap. Thank you so much for joining us today. Don't forget to join us on Friday when we have the Social Polish Diaries. And on that platform, we can get to read your stories concerning the topic that we have discussed about today. which is the power of words. Share a story about what situation that really changed your life, either positively or negatively, or your journey as you continue to be inspired to use positive words, knowing that there is power in our words. So until next time, do have a wonderful, wonderful week. I enjoyed being with you all. Thank you so much, Wale. Thank you so much, Obina. Thank you, Psych Inspire. Thank you so much, everyone. Chazokan, Antise, Adeze. Thank you so much, everyone. Kenji, thank you. I love you all. Uncle Ken, thank you so much. You're all welcome. Thank you so much for joining. Until next time, you have a wonderful rest of the week. I will definitely see you on Friday. God bless you. Bye-bye.